So we do know quite a bit about the risks of COVID. As I said, 80% never become symptomatic. 20% do become symptomatic, and of those 20% who are symptomatic, many of them are hospitalized, and about of those hospitalized, 15 to 20% end up being seriously ill. The ones who are most at risk then of becoming seriously ill or dying are those who are older, meaning over 60, and the older you are, the higher the risk. And those individuals who have underlying diseases, diabetes, severe lung disease, heart disease, kidney disease, those people are at higher risk of having serious consequences of COVID. We've seen very few cases in children. They appear in general to have mild disease. So the answer is older individuals are at higher risk of many respiratory infections, including influenza and other respiratory illnesses. So certainly if you have a parent, grandparent, great-grandparent, and you are ill, meaning with respiratory symptoms, fever, shortness of breath, cough, then you should not visit older people, particularly if they're frail enough to be in a nursing home. You should wait till your disease has resolved before you visit them. Turning it around, what can the older persons do themselves? Again, particularly those that are frail with multiple other underlying medical problems, should obviously screen people before they come visit, certainly asking your children, your friends, please don't visit if you're ill. And second of all, particularly if we start seeing community acquisition, meaning cases in the community that are acquired and we don't know about, then to the extent possible, they should try and avoid situations where they're sitting for long periods of time with many people around them. Things like movie houses would be an example. And they should obviously try and see smaller groups of people and not into large groups of individuals. Obviously, if they see someone near them who's coughing, sneezing, and particularly not using a tissue while they're shopping, they should move more than 6 feet away. It is true for droplet spread diseases, you know, the official guidance is 3 to 6 feet. I'm being conservative, stay 6 feet apart, but that's about as far as the droplets go. Now, we have some true airborne diseases, which COVID is not an airborne disease, but they would include things like chickenpox, tuberculosis, for instance, measles. All of those can be transmitted over many different feet, but COVID is not like that. COVID is only transmitted by a maximum of 6 feet, as far as we know. It's a respiratory disease. These tend to peak in anywhere from early mid-fall to early spring. So as we go into spring and then into summer, I think that the number of respiratory infections from COVID as well as from other respiratory viruses like influenza will go down quite a bit. Although I can't guarantee that for COVID because most of us are susceptible. And I do expect, again, just my personal opinion, that next year when we have our respiratory season in the winter, we will see COVID peak again. And then after that, it'll just become a circulating, less common than flu, but circulating respiratory infectious disease. We need to save the masks for the people most at risk. There are certainly some groups of patients that should be wearing a mask, particularly when they're in social gatherings. Certainly a cystic fibrosis patient, if they might be near other cystic fibrosis patients, should be wearing a mask because they can transmit pathogens. Our highly immunocompromised patients who have undergone a bone marrow or recent organ transplant, heart or lung, certainly based on their physician's advice, if they're in groups, a mask is very reasonable. So there are certain groups of patients who should be wearing a mask. Should everybody else be wearing a mask while they're walking around the street, going to the supermarket? The answer is no, because we do need to save the masks for our patients and other friends who need it for more serious medical problems and for our healthcare providers when they're in close proximity to a potentially infectious patient.